Nathalia's flooded waterway has finally reached its peak, but there's no relief in sight for the community's exhausted residents who've defied evacuation warnings and battled to seal leaks in strange levees.
Another frantic all-night effort as water crept through any gap it could find. A sleepless army determined to reinforce the levee that stands between Nathalia and a vast, threatening sea.
It's just unbelievable how the community has supported their own township.
No rest for teams topping up sandbags through the night, and today they were back again. As leaks spring up, the council is trialling new ways to stop them.
It'll swell up and I reckon it's going to block it off completely. No dramas.
All eyes are on the broken creek. It's finally reached its peak of 3.25 metres.
We'll be watching that for the next probably 3 to 4 days because we'll have water up around this height for that period of time.
I've got the car packed ready for in case it does break.
Our kids might just get out and we've just come back in to pick up a few things.
The evacuation warning remains in place. 165 people have left, but 90% of locals remain.
Why would you leave if you left? There'd be no one here to do the sandbagging or protect the town.
It's the first time these aluminium levees have been used in Victoria, but the SES says while there's so much pressure against them, there's always a risk they'll fail.
Many are quietly confident the levees will hold, but not confident enough to ease up on their efforts.
No, better keep going until everything's all good.
On the other side of the creek, the outskirts of the town remain underwater. Emma O'Sullivan, 10 News.
Emma joins us live now from Nathalia. And Emma, you have some breaking news from the latest flood briefing.
Yes, Mel. Senior SES commanders have just started briefing a community meeting to tell them the worst isn't over. While the creek has peaked, these high levels are expected to hang around for a few days and the levees are under enormous pressure. For instance, at the northern levee, on one side you've got the dry Murray Valley Highway. On the other side, immediately over, you've got water that's 3 metres deep. For those who've decided to leave, while the SES is asking them to stay away until they issue a notice saying that it's safe to return. For those who have remained, while they're again being reminded that the integrity of the levees can't be guaranteed, the SES and the council has engineers and levee experts keeping them updated.
Tens Emma O'Sullivan live there from Nathalia.